Listening Library presents Field Trip by Gary Paulsen and Jim Paulsen. Read for you by Mike Chamberlain and John H. Mayer. Chapter 1. The Letters. I stagger in the back door after hockey, wrecked. Thursdays are brutal. Strength and conditioning training for 90 minutes before school. Then, after the last bell rings, back to the rink for a few hours on the ice. After 20 years of hard work, well, I'm 14, but ice time is way longer than real time, I finally made the best hockey team in town. When I get home, all I want to do is eat and go to bed. A guy needs some peace and quiet. But peace and quiet are pretty rare at our house these days. Last summer, Dad suddenly quit his job as a corporate pencil pusher and started a business flipping houses. No, he's not a giant. Flipping means he buys crummy places, fixes them up, and sells them. He's pretty good at what he does, I have to admit that. He's bought dumps that look to me like nothing but rotting drywall and turned them into show houses. But there's always the awful wait for the house to sell. And when Dad bugs out about things that are beyond his control, he rips apart something in our house. For the past 10 months, we've been living in a construction zone. When Dad's not at work, which is most of the time, he's home tearing down walls and pulling up floors. Initially, I was really into Dad's company, Duffy and Son, and I worked for him last summer. But once I made the travel hockey team, I didn't have time for that. And I can't stand not having running water and being able to see through the floor of my bedroom because Dad yanked up the boards. He and Mom love the constant remodeling. He thrives on the challenges. She enjoys the new stuff. But I hate it. Today, it's quiet when I get home. Just Atticus and Conor waiting for me. It's been this way for months. Me and the guys. Sometimes I think they're the only ones who notice if I come home, and they're the main reasons I come home at all. Atticus sneezes as I walk into the kitchen. The drywall dust bothers his nose. He's our 15-year-old border collie, and the construction makes him extra cranky. Connor, the rescue puppy we adopted last summer, caroms around the corner into the kitchen, sliding into the wall with a thump. His paws scrabble on the new hardwood floor. He hasn't gotten the hang of the slick wood yet. And he bats his stuffed lamb my way to throw it for him to chase. But I kick it so the toy skids to him, puck-like. He pounces on it. Goal denied. I have visions of putting together the world's first ever canine hockey team. I am all hockey all the time. Awesome defense, buddy. I try to get Connor to high-five me, but he tips over when he lifts a paw. He might be a little too clumsy for hockey. Atticus just watches the toy slide past him and then looks at me sadly. He'll catch frisbees and balls, but hockey isn't his thing. Weird that we're related. Atticus whines and stares at the slow cooker on the counter. Beef stroganoff today, I tell him. His ears prick up. I've been cooking for myself all year, and a slow cooker is a hungry guy's best friend. I had to start making my own meals after Mom took on the finances at Duffy and Son. She still works full-time at her old job, but now she takes care of our books in the evenings and on weekends. I looked up a bunch of easy recipes and started fending for myself. I don't know what Mom and Dad do about meals. I can't remember the last time we ate together. I dump kibble in two bowls for the guys, then sit down with my plate of beefy noodles, and the three of us start inhaling supper. I look through the mail as I eat. Two envelopes are addressed to the parents of Ben Duffy. My name is on them, I assure Atticus, who has stopped eating to watch me, his ears flattened in disapproval. It's okay. The first letter is from the assistant vice principal at my school. Atticus and Connor are nudging my thigh, so I read the letter to them. Ben's attendance record is less than optimal. That means I miss a lot of school because my hockey team has been red hot this season and we've been invited to a bunch of tourneys and skills seminars, I explain. Atticus groans and lies down, and Connor scratches an itch behind his ear and falls over again. Furthermore, he seems to be coasting in his classes, failing to live up to his full potential. That's because I give everything I've got to the game. Duh. Atticus sighs and rests his chin on my gear bag. He understands my priorities. Connor chews the bag's shoulder strap. He has yet to perfect supportive gestures the way Atticus has. Good thing I intercepted this note, I tell them. It's the kind of thing that would worry Mom and Dad, and they have enough going on these days without school causing trouble. I know what I'm doing. Atticus tilts his head, doubtful. Connor snatches the letter from my hand. That's what I think. Out of sight, out of mind. Thanks, dude. I open the second envelope. This letter is a lot more interesting, and I jump up and start pacing as I read because I'm so psyched. The guys follow me back and forth across the kitchen. Listen to this. Brookdale Hockey Academy is hosting invitational tryouts for the best and brightest hockey talent. Beginning this fall term, BHA will offer a live-in facility featuring a high-quality classroom education along with daily training for the country's highest caliber student athletes. We are pleased to inform you that your son, Ben Duffy, has earned an invitation to apply for admission to our elite program. My mind is racing. I've heard rumors about a place like this starting up a few hours away. I guess the academy is a go. And they want me. It's perfect. Classes scheduled around practice, living and training with the best players, being coached by brilliant hockey minds. I'll finally be surrounded by people who get where my head is at and who will encourage my dream of playing pro someday. Not like Mom and Dad, who only nag me about leaving smelly gear in the kitchen and show up late to my games when they can even make them. Atticus paws at my leg, and Connor, who studies Atticus like he's going to be tested later, pounces on my shoe. I stop pacing and grin down at them. Best news ever! Atticus makes a noise that sounds like, no! But that can't be right. He's always got my back. I turn my attention back to the letter. Tryouts are this weekend. Acceptances are being announced next week. That's fast. Figures. Hockey is the fastest game on earth. I have to call Coach, ask around to see if any of the other guys on the team are trying out, and arrange a ride.
A ride where?
Dad comes in from the garage. He's carrying blueprints and paperwork. He must have bought a new house to flip. The Duffy family is on a winning streak today. I'm so jazzed. I can't even find the words. I hand over the letter and wait for him to read the words that will change my life forever.
Boarding school?
Dad frowns at the letter.
We never talked about you going away to school, much less a hockey academy.
He makes air quotes when he says academy, as if he doubts it's a real school. Mom and I will have to talk this over, Ben. It's a big decision.
Very expensive, too.
It's not a decision. It's destiny. You know how hard I've been working and how I've sacrificed. I wait and let that sink in. Last summer, Dad had to go back on his promise to let me go to hockey camp because of the new business. It was a heartbreaker, but I joined a summer league in town and learned a lot, really upped my game. The disappointment about camp helped me develop new skills, and I've been working my butt off ever since. Playing hockey is all I've dreamed of and worked for since I was 5 and got my first skates. Hockey's not just a game to me, Dad. It's what I love more than anything else in the world. And this is the opportunity of a lifetime.
You said that about camp last summer. and the travel team last fall. Well, when you're a true blue player like me, whose entire future revolves around hockey, you're bound to have more opportunities of a lifetime than average people.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.